Hi, my dear children. So today we are going to learn a new lesson in grammar, and that is pronouns. The chapter pronouns is 14th chapter in your grammar textbook, and it is in page number 43. Shall we start the class? Yes. What is a pronoun? What is a pronoun? Words that are used in the place of a noun to avoid repetition. So what are pronouns? Words that are used in the place of a noun to avoid repetition. The donkey fell down because the donkey was tired. The donkey fell down because the donkey was tired. Here the first word phrase is the donkey. Again it is repeated in the second half of the sentence. So what can we rewrite? The donkey fell down because it was tired. So here repetition is avoided, isn't it? The repetition, the donkey, is avoided in the second sentence, and it is used as with the pronoun it in the second sentence. I, he, she, her, it, they and them are the pronouns mostly used. Moving on, I, me, mine are used when it means ourselves or single person. We, us, used for two or more persons. Mine, yours, ours, his, hers and theirs are called possessive pronouns, because they show that something belongs to somebody. Example, the book belongs to me. So instead of belongs to me, which pronoun can be used? The book is mine. The book belongs to you. The book is yours. So this is possessive pronouns. Possessive pronouns are pronouns which help us to understand some things belong to someone. Now turn to page number 43, exercise A. Underline the pronouns in the following sentences. First one, Sita told Geeta that she should work hard. Sita told Geeta that she should work hard. What is the pronoun there? It is she. Rima's mother told her to rest after school hours. Rima's mother told her to rest after school hours. The pronoun is her there. Okay. Now, exercise B. Rewrite the following passage by replacing the underlined words with pronouns given in brackets. Tommy, the dog, wanted to grow horns like Gauri, the cow. Actually, one day, Tommy ran after Gauri and Gauri scared him by pointing her horns towards Tommy. So, some words are underlined there. So, you have to replace it with the pronouns. So, what is the second line says? Tommy ran after Gauri and Gauri is returned. So, what it will be? Gauri is a girl. So, it will be cow. So, it is a female gender. So, we can use she scared him by pointing her horns towards Tommy. Tommy is a dog, so it will be him. We can use the pronoun him. Similarly, you have to use pronouns instead. You have to replace underlined word with the proper pronoun. Okay. Now the exercise C on page number 45. Rewrite the sentences using possessive pronouns. The car belongs to him. So what will be the answer here? What did we use? The book belongs to me. The book is mine. Isn't it? The book is mine. The book belongs to you. The book is yours. And here the first exercise, first question is, the car belongs to him. So what it will be? That is his car. The doll belongs to me. The doll is hers. I'm sorry. The doll belongs to her. So what will be the answer? The doll is hers. The next one. The house belongs to them. It is their house, isn't it? So the house is theirs. The bag belongs to me. The bag is mine. Okay, so similarly you have to do the rest of the questions given there. The next is personal pronouns. Personal pronouns means there is first person, second person and third person. First person means the person who is speaking. So if I am telling something, so I am the speaker and I am talking to you. So who are you? You are the second person. I am the one who is speaking, so I am the speaker and I am the first person. You are listening and you are the second one, so you are the second person. And if we both are talking and we are telling about someone else, that group or that person becomes the third person. So I am telling, for example, I bought a new bag. So I is the pronoun there, isn't it? I bought a new bag. Did you buy a new bag? So I'm asking you, did you buy a new bag? So you is the pronoun there. Understood? Now the third person, we are talking. Did she buy a new car? We are asking. We both are talking and we are talking about someone else. So we will be asking or we will be telling or talking. Did she buy a new car? So she is the pronoun. That building belongs to them. Again, we are talking about someone. The building belongs to them. So it is a third person. Understood? Yes. Now, personal pronouns are pronouns used in place of people, animals and things. I, me, mine, we, us. These are first person pronouns used for first person. You, yours, pronoun which is used for second person. They, them, theirs, pronouns used for third person. It, used for things, places or animals. It can be anything like that. Understood? Now moving on, there is exercise D. When you reached home, you told your mother, luck was by my side today. Now think about your lucky day and write about it in first person. So you are the person who is writing, so you have to write. Understood? You can do it by yourself. The next one, underline the pronouns and write against each sentence the form of pronoun or person used. State whether it is a first person, second person or third person. So you, what do you have to do? You have to underline the pronouns and you have to say whether it is first person, second person or third person. First one, lions are royal animals. They are called the king of the jungle. The first sentence, lions are royal animals. And second sentence, what is it said? They are called the king of the jungle. Isn't it? So in the second sentence, they are used. They means it is a pronoun. And what it is? Is it first, second or third? What is it? It is the third person. They, them, theirs. All these are third person pronouns. Second question. I like the cakes made by mother. What is the pronoun used? I, and I is the first person. You are such a soft spoken person. That means the first person is talking to the second person. So you is used and you is the pronoun used for second person. Understood? So similarly you have to do the rest of the exercises. Now exercise F, fill in the blanks with the correct form of personal pronouns. Please come here. Dash want to talk to you. So Please come here. I want to talk to you. Personal pronouns. Okay. Come and tell dash what happened. What is the personal pronoun? Come and tell me what happened. Come and tell us what happened. It can be me or us. You have to use the personal pronouns. Third one. My mother told dash about my great grandfather. My mother told me about my great grandfather. Understood. So the next one is singular, and the rest of the exercise in questions in exercise F should be done by yourself. Try to do it by yourself. Okay. So in the next class we will discuss about it and I will check it. The next one is singular and plural pronouns. Singular and plural pronouns. Singular is I, me. When it comes to plural pronouns, we, us. You is you itself. In singular one, she, her, he, him, it. But when all these things come in plural, it becomes they, them. Once again, in singular form, the pronouns I, me will become we, us in plural form. You in singular is you itself in plural. Singular form of pronouns she, her, he, him, it will become they and them for plural pronouns. Understood. So please learn this. It will be very easy for you to understand. It's on page number 47 itself. Moving on, the next one is genders. So different pronouns are used for different genders. You will see to that. Genders. Masculine gender, he, him. What is the pronoun? He, him. Feminine gender, it is she, her. It is a common gender, we use I, we, me, us, you. Okay, these are the common pronouns, genders. When it is neuter, that means it's neither masculine or feminine, we use it as the pronoun. Is it clear for you? Now exercise G. Underline the personal pronouns in the following sentences. She painted a picture for us. We liked it a lot. What do you have to do? You have to underline the personal pronouns. Okay. She painted a picture of us. We liked it a lot. Which are the personal pronouns? She, us, we, it. Okay. These are the personal pronouns in the first sentence. I asked my mother the recipe of chocolate muffins. She told me and I found it very simple. So what is it? I is the pronoun used there. Personal pronouns, okay. She, again I, and at last it. Okay. I'm sorry, it is not coming there. It is I, she, and I in that particular sentence. Okay. Yes. You may do the rest of the exercises by yourself and I shall check it in the next class. Now exercise H on page number 48. Show whether the pronouns are singular. If it is singular, you have to write S. If it is plural, you have to write P. If it is male, M. Female, M. N for neuter, C for common. Okay, the first one, there is an example. She dash is a good girl. So what is it? She is a singular, isn't it? And what is it? What gender it is? Female or masculine? Feminine or masculine? It is feminine, female. So F is written there. So the first one, he dash did not like the tomato soup she made for him. The first one is he and he is singular. So you have to write First one is he. So in the bracket you have to write S singular and he is male. So write like this, male. She did not like the tomato soup. She is female. It is singular and it is female. Understood. Last one is him. Him is singular. It is male. Understood. The second one, she is such a nice person that he wants to be her friend. Once again, she is such a nice person that he wants to be her friend. The first pronoun in given bold is she. So she is singular. So S for singular, female. So F for female. The next one is he. He is singular. So S for singular, he is male. So M for male. Understood. So similarly, you have to do the rest of the exercises and complete it before the next class. Okay. The teacher will be asking you all the questions. So complete it by yourself and be ready for textbooks to be checked. Okay. Now the last exercise. Fill in the blanks with suitable pronouns. Dash are late for the test. It is are. So it is should be plural, isn't it? So we are. It is personal pronouns you have to use. So we are late for the test. Okay. The second one, Meena and Tina play badminton. Dash practice in the evening. Meena and Tina play badminton. There are two people. And if it is two people, what will we use? They practice in the evening. They is a personal pronoun used there. Understood. It is talking about third person. So, and we are telling about them. So, it is they. Is it clear? Yes. So, I hope you all understood what is pronoun. And please learn the chapter and complete all your notes. And be ready to meet in the next class. Thank you.